part of the university's mission is outreach to the community. I mean, we're here to help the community. So the effort we're doing in this lab is part of the university-wide effort to use our 3D printers as much as we can. In this case, we're producing face shields.
The whole process here is I basically load up a disposable build tray or build sheet into the printer. And then once the printer finishes printing, I take that out and put the parts in a solvent tank that dissolves the support material. And then I rinse that off and the parts are good to go. Total, I'm just about doing 100 parts per day. So one of the benefits to the 3D printing, while it's not quite as fast as some of the more manual methods that the Boyd Lab is using, we are able to run a lights out scenario. So I can start a print at 9 in the morning and then go home and come back the next day to 100 parts finished.
So as you can see right here, the black part is the 3D part that Taylor printed yesterday, the halo as we call it. And then last night I added to it, I cut out a piece of plastic, used my office hole puncher to punch a few holes and to mount that on there. And then I took some of the elastic that we're using and I just cut a little hole in it and added it on. How they're gonna do it in the final design may differ from this, but this just is to give you an idea. So then you put it over your head like this, and then it protects your mask. What I'm wearing is not an N95 mask like the doctors and nurses would be wearing. It's just a homemade cotton face mask, but it gives you the idea of how it would work.